Hello and welcome to marketing91.com. In this video, we are going to cover the topic on leadership theories. Before we proceed any further, please do note that we publish 3 videos daily on YouTube. So please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Now let's start with what is a leadership theory. Philosophies that throw light on how and why people transform into leaders are known as leadership theories. They describe the reason and the way some individuals become leaders. Characteristics and conduct that individuals can embrace to enhance their leadership abilities are the focus of these leadership theories. Now let's look at some of the leadership theories. Please note, most of these leadership theories are covered by us in individual videos. Now let's start with the first one, the great man theory. The great person theory or the great man theory states that leaders have inborn leadership skills like confidence, charm, social skills, interaction skills, and intellect. According to the theory, leadership capabilities are inborn. It states that leaders cannot be created but are born. It says that leaders leading when situations arise is predetermined and they are fearless and legendary when they do. Since leadership, especially multi-leadership in historical times were reserved for men, the coined word was great man. Moving on to the next one, the trait theory. The characteristics of both successful and failed leaders are the basis of the trait theory. This theory focuses successful leadership. The characteristics of potential leaders are compared with those recognized in this theory to figure out the probability of successful leadership. Leadership characteristics are recognized by experts studying the trait theory through varying viewpoints. Physical attributes like height, weight and appearance, familial background, demographics like education and age, and intelligence comprising knowledge, decisiveness and judgment are focused on by them. Next is the contingency theory. Various variables that establish the appropriate leadership style to be used in a particular situation or setting are highlighted by the contingency theory. The belief that a single leadership style is not appropriate for all situations is the basis of this theory. According to White and Hodgson, 2 well-known leadership researchers, the best leadership style is the one that finds the correct equilibrium between context, requirements, and conduct. Not only do good leaders have the appropriate qualities to lead, but they are also capable of assessing the situations and their followers' needs. Next is the situational theory. Like the contingency theory, the situational theory also believes that a single leadership style is not appropriate for all situations. As suggested by the name, the theory states that the circumstance concludes which leadership technique to use. Aspects like the nature of task, type of followers, etc. in the situation must be evaluated to determine the leadership style to be used. Paul Harley, an American professor, and Ken Blanchard, a leadership guru, proposed that situational theory combines the leadership style and followers' maturity levels. Moving on to the next one, behavioral theory. Behavioral theory is the outcome of multiple learned skills. Instead of focusing on the leader's characteristics or attributes, behavioral theory focuses on a particular behavior. Technical, human, and conceptual skills are the 3 skills needed for a person to be a leader. Technical skill is what a leader knows about the technique or process. Human skill refers to the leader's ability to communicate with others. And conceptual skill is the leader's ability to devise ideas for smooth running of the company or society. Moving on to the next one, transformational theory. Leaders who are charming and inspirational and motivate their followers to change and improve at task are the focus of this theory. Transformational leaders have the ability to encourage their followers by showing them the importance of the task and benefits of completing it. Along with the focus on the performance of the team as a whole, they also give importance and encouragement to individual members so they reach their full potential. As stated in the theory, there are 4 components to transformational leadership, sometimes referred to as the 4 I's. First, idealized influence. Next, inspirational motivation. Next, individualized consideration and intellectual stimulation. And moving on to our final theory, transactional theory. Also known as the exchange theory of leadership or management theory, transactional theory focuses on teamwork, structuring, and supervision. These theories base their leadership actions on punishments and rewards. Transactional leadership involves motivating and directing followers primarily through appealing to their own self-interest. This theory is very commonly used by companies. Advocates of this theory encourage employees through punishments and rewards. So that's it, folks. This brings an end to the topic on leadership theories. As I mentioned earlier, most of these theories are covered in individual video by us. These are some of the sources and links referred to for the content in this video. If you've liked the video, do subscribe to our channel where you'll witness 3 new videos daily. Additionally, if you want to view these videos in an organized manner, you can visit freecourses.net where all our videos are arranged in the form of courses. Thank you and see you in the next video.